Hello YouTube. It's time to announce the winner for my hour-long giveaway. It's been about a week since the giveaway closed, and it's finally time to do this. If you recall, there was a few different ways of entering. Described it here. It was a little confusing, but I think we figured it out. The main way was by being a subscriber at close, and there was 1,772 subscribers at close. The other way was by doing referrals, and I got 3 referrals of new subscribers, which I appreciated. And so that's 1,775 subscriber referrals. The other way to subscribe was by doing a walkthrough video based on a scramble I provided, and I got 19 walkthrough videos. Times 20 entries each, and there are 80 walkthrough entries. It's about a 80 to 20 percent ratio of subscribers to walkthroughs. The reason that's significant is out of the 2,155 total entries, the walkthrough ones will be easier to figure out than the 1775 subscribers, because I just found out that YouTube can't export a subscriber list. And so that makes this complicated. I'll figure it out if I need to, but the first thing I'm gonna do is figure out if the winner is gonna be a subscriber or from a walkthrough entry. The way I'm gonna do that is I'm gonna use a random number generator. If the number is 1775 or lower, it'll get complicated, we'll figure it out. If the number is above 1775, then I just need to pick from the 19 walkthrough videos I got. So let's open a new window and pick a number between 1 and 2155. And the number is 1845. That's north of 1775. So that means it will be picking from a walkthrough video. This is actually much easier to administer at this point. So now that we know it's going to be a walkthrough video, I put together a playlist of all of the walkthroughs. They're over here, they're numbered 1 through 19, and I'll link to the playlist. But here's the 19 entries. So now I'm gonna go back to the randomizer. I'm gonna type 19, and whichever one comes up here will go to the playlist, and that'll be the winner. The winner is 6. So when we go over here, we find Cubing Cubes.
Say I'm here with a walkthrough song.
Here's the entry. And Cubing Cubes, I'll link to Cubing Cubes' channel, and I'll get in touch so that we could get the cube sent off. Congratulations to Cubing Cubes. And the last thing I wanted to try was to do my own walkthrough on the same scramble. I'm not really that good at these, but I thought if I'm gonna ask people to do it, I should do it myself. So here it goes. So here we are, halftime in the Germany-Ghana game, and having invited people to do their own walkthroughs, I thought I should probably do mine. Let's jump right to it. So the first thing I see when thinking about the cross is that green can go down in one turn. It's oriented properly and over blue, which is its opposite. And if I do that, I can see orange can go under red as the opposite and also be properly positioned while turning this face and the front face and having blue and red also get oriented for easy placement. So I think that's what I would do. I would do green down, orange under red, fix the orientation of both these. And the nice thing is that red, we know, can't go here. It's gonna need to go one over, so just do a D prime, put red down. And the nice thing is with one more turn, this is the position blue should be in. So with one more D prime move, D can go here, taking this position, and all of the edges will be properly oriented under their centers. So And that's the cross. Let's see. The next thing I see is a fairly easy blue-orange pair. So let's do that. Paired them up for placement. It's going to need to be put in the back left corner. There we go. And the next thing I see is the a green-red. It's going to be placed here. Let's see. I can pair them anywhere, but I think it's going to be easier if I pair it back here. So now they're paired. Bring them around. Well, here I have a choice to make. I was going to bring them around and do a hedge slammer, but I don't like the way that's going to leave me for the next pair, which will probably be green, green-orange. So instead, I'm going to rotate and place it in the front left, leaving the green-orange slot ready for the next pair, which is here. And that leaves just one pair, which is blue-red. They're already properly positioned with respect to each other. You see to be put in this back slot. I'm going to do a rotation and put those in. And that leaves the easy B. And a J perm, which I always orient the solid bar to the left. So I know when I'm done with this, I'll have to AUF by doing a U prime. So there we go. That's my walkthrough. There was a lot of great walkthroughs. There was a lot of great walkthroughs that got submitted, and I really encourage people to check out that playlist of walkthroughs. But undeniably, the best solve on this scramble would have to be Mats Valk setting the 3x3 single record at 5.55 seconds.
Bump!
Whoa.